Hello students, in today's lecture we are going to do summary and analysis of The Prince by Nicolo Machiavelli. So we'll do chapter wise analysis of the theory which is given by Machiavelli in this book The Prince. So first of all, we are going to take chapter 1 and 2. We are taking these chapters together because both the chapters are very small. So here we find that in this chapter there are two types of states which has been discussed by Machiavelli. One is republic and principalities. Machiavelli declares that he will not discuss republic, examining only how principalities may be acquired and governed. According to Machiavelli, principalities are inherited or new. So he says that new principalities are either annexed to a ruler's existing territory or are completely new. So new principalities are either used to being ruled by a prince or are used to being free. New principalities are acquired by luck or by strength, according to Machiavelli. Now he talks about hereditary principalities, which are used to being ruled by the princess's family, are easy to maintain. So he says this because tradition keeps the prince's position stable as long as he does not make himself hated. So from the analysis of this two chapter, we can say that in chapter 1, Machiavelli traces the basic outlines for discussion that will take him through chapter 11. The different types of states, how to acquire them, and the difficulties they present to a ruler. Machiavelli refers to republics, which are governed by their citizens, and principalities or princely states, which are governed by a single strong ruler, a prince we can say. Because he is addressing one of those princes, he avoids any discussion of republican government except to note that republics conquered by a new prince are used to living free. A theme he returns to in later chapters that we will see later when we'll go to the later part of this book. So in many of his other works as well, Machiavelli passionately defended republican forms of government, and he suffered for this defense of the Florentine Republic which the Medici now ruled. Hereditary principalities, according to Machiavelli, are those in which rule is passed down among members of one family. Machiavelli considers these the easiest to govern and therefore disposes of the subject by observing that minimally competent prince can hold on to one. At the end of chapter 2, we see that Machiavelli makes the first of his many observations about human nature, noting that people are inclined to forget that even old established governments are governments were innovation once. Now moving on to chapter 3, he says that it's rather long as compared to chapter 1 and 2. So here he says that new principalities always cause problems for the prince. People are willing to change rulers to better their own lot, but they soon discover that things have gotten worse because a new ruler must harm those he conquers. So here Machiavelli says that then you have as enemies those you harmed while seizing power, as well as those you put in power, because you can never satisfy all of their ambitions. He says that if conquered, territories annexed to yours are similar in location and customs, it is easy to keep them, especially if they were hereditary principalities not used to independence. Now further he says that as long as you do not change their way of life, you need only wipe out the old ruling family to keep them. He further adds that if new territories are different in language and custom, they are difficult to keep. So he says the best method are to go and live there yourself, so that you can establish colonies in them and to protect the neighboring minor powers, to weaken strong faction within the state and to guard against foreign powers. Here he says that it is important to deal with developing political problem early. rather than wait until it is too late, because war can never be avoided, only postponed, as is said by Machiavelli. So King Louis did not follow these politics policies in Italy, therefore failed to keep his territories, according to Machiavelli. He also erred by making the church more powerful. Here he is talking about the mistakes of King Louis. Now, because to make others powerful is to weaken yourself. When you are giving your strength to somebody else, that means you are weakening your own powers, according to Machiavelli. So in the analysis of this chapter, we feel that he is talking about the annexed territories. Machiavelli makes several of the observations that have contributed to his reputation for ruthlessness. And we find a hint of those ruthlessness in this chapter, that is chapter 3. First, he notes that conquering rulers must inevitably injure those they conquer. Then he advises conquerors to exterminate old ruling families to avoid threats to their power. Discussing colonies, he says that they are effective because the only ones they harm are a few poor people who lose their homes and lands, and these people are in no position to harm the prince. So in this context, he makes the famous statement that men should either be cursed or destroyed, meaning that if you must harm people, harm them so severely that they will not be able to take revenge on you. So these are the words of Machiavelli. And he further says that other pieces of advice that is more human, he suggests that he justifies colonies as an effective means to control a new territory because they harm the minimum number of people. And it is impossible for a new ruler to avoid doing some harm to his subjects. Colonies are definitely more desirable than occupation by any army, which harms everyone in the new state and makes the new ruler hated. While Machiavelli sees violence as an unavoidable part of government, he also strives for the most efficient and controlled use of violence. Yet, like, we find that Machiavelli advises the prince to act humanly only when doing so has a tangible benefit. Until he sees the benefit of being humanly, he should not be humanly, according to Machiavelli. Not because doing is ethical. I mean, he should not become human because it is ethical. He should be humanly only if it is giving him tangible benefit, giving benefit to the prince tangibly, right? So Machiavelli's advice to the prince is always grounded in the best way to acquire and increase power rather than in consideration of right or wrong. Power is depicted as a scarce resource to be energetically collected and carefully guarded. As in Machiavelli's observation that giving power to another takes power from yourself or your own self. That means by giving power to others, you're draining or you're weakening your powers. So this intensely competitive outlook precludes ideas of cooperation or shared responsibility. So much of this chapter is concerned with detailed analysis of the examples provided by the Romans in ancient times and King Louis in more recent times. Louis's invasion was the beginning of a turbulent period of period for Italy, and its repercussions occupy Machiavelli's attention later in this book. So we'll study about all these things in the later chapters. That's all for today. Thank you all.